Morning, it's Al from Boston. How are you? I just wanted to take a moment and just talk about some of the strange, unusual activities we've been seeing regarding our friends over in Chicago and New York. This really struck out as peculiar to me, but I think you might be able to infer what's going on. So recently, Citadel hired Joe Biden's chief of security for the Secret Service, David Chow. David Chow is going to start on the 3rd of January as the deputy head of security for Citadel. Now, let's talk about what that means. That means every kind of security measures that protects the IP, the assets, the people of Citadel Securities. David Cho has been with the Secret Service for 25 years. He is of Korean American descent, and he is probably well connected within the confines of the federal government. Now, I don't want to start inferring that he will use his past connections to do background checks on us and so on and so forth. But it's feasible that he, Ken Griffin and his team picked him up to posture for any possible things that could happen in the next 48 hours, 100 hours, next month, next week, whatever. He could be hedging something for the future. He's trying to hedge something. There's a play here, but he is obviously posturing. When they reached out to him, he declined to comment on working for Citadel. They must have offered him an exuberant amount of money to come work for Citadel. But you can look at his background. I mean, he's got pretty extensive background. Exceptional Gold Service Medal from the Secret Service, Homeland Security. He protected Donald Trump. There is a variety of stuff this guy has probably done working with military. He's probably an operator at one point. Maybe we don't know if he's got military service, but we can definitely say he's got operational understanding of how the system works in terms of paramilitary type operations or whatever, anything to do with protecting the service Joe Biden rather. But I thought it was interesting. I thought it was very fascinating that you would hire him of all people. Joe Biden, it's safe to say he's got dementia, or he's got early stage dementia by the way he talks. And it's common, I think, for everybody. And we all know what's going on there. We just don't talk about it. But one of the things that I'm going to infer is that when Citadel is in the worst shape possible, he's going to make the phone call to Joe. Now, we talked about in other videos how Joe Biden relies on PPT, Powell, and Gensler to sort out the business of the economy, all this other stuff that's going on with the economy right now, the market. But Citadel very cleverly outfoxed them and put David Cho, a very close personal friend of probably Biden, Melinda Beck, because he was in charge of a security detail, to reach out to them when the day happens where Ken is at systematic risk and he needs a friend, and David makes the phone call to Joe and say, "Can I set a meeting with you? This is what's going on. This is what's happening. This is what they're not telling you, blah, blah, blah." And David Cho does a data dump onto Joe Biden. Joe Biden says, "Okay, I'm going to give you this favor, David," and boom, next thing you know, somehow he gets a lifeline, he gets a bailout, or he gets some kind of executive order or something to that effect. I could see that happen. Absolutely. Now, I'm just going to say this. I'm not certain 100%. I'm talking about possibilities. I'm talking about things that could happen that we are, going to war game. How many ways can this happen? Remember, we talked about critical thinking, and how many ways can this possibly happen? Why would they hire somebody like David Cho, right? So keep that in mind. Let's go to the next thing. The next thing is also kind of a strange turn of events. Ed, I forgot his last name. It's like Sawchuk, who is a Twitter guy, came up with some very interesting information in regards to the short interest and where the folks over at Citadel have been hiding it. I want to introduce Justin Chow, no relation to Leslie Chow.
He is the former head of global business development and relations and OTC for Citadel. He is a proprietary trader. He's got some very interesting, backgrounds, especially distressed credit and event-driven hedge fund. Now, who do you know in that part of the world that is distressed right now, Evergrande? Who do you know? Do you think of anybody? Do you know anybody that might be distressed? Well, I would be willing to bet that this guy in Hong Kong is probably the guy that's facilitating and, you know, making sure that the Evergrande, cash bond thing is going through, and somehow Citadel makes something off of it or has some kind of leverage there. But interesting background, this guy. This is his LinkedIn, former Citadel employee, but they left. This is what Ed picked up, just where they hide in it, and really interesting stuff. You check out his Twitter, you'll see it. But Citadel Securities, they're masking the IP, they're masking the short interest in Chicago, they're masking it in Singapore, very similarly how they did with Brazil and GME. Look at this. 79% is going through the dark pool. Imagine that. Off exchange. Unlit. Imagine that, right? So one of the things I want to say is this. The folks over at Citadel are not stupid. They're not dumb people. They're being strategic, just like we're being strategic. They're wanting to get things lined up and, in case something happens. And that's what they're doing. They're very smart. Citadel, these are the three guys that quit that worked for Ken. Kevin Quek, Tech Hui, and Senior Associate Justin Chow. And this was dated in 2015. They've maintained the relationship with Chow until, today. And then they're just, amping up now. But I thought that was interesting. This is Justin Chow's Twitter account. He's got a very, very open Twitter account, Citadel, DRW, former Cumberland, global macro trader. So he's a player in the game. He knows what's going on. Somewhat active on Twitter. But I just thought it was interesting that this guy came along and because of, remember, we talked about in the other videos how when Ken takes on an employee, he's not just working for Ken on business hours and that period of time where he actually works directly under Ken. He works for him later. I would venture to say that Justin Chow got his money to start his fund through Citadel and through Ken Griffin himself. And that's how he was posturing himself. Ken is a very strategic thinker. His strategy team, the guy that gets all the analytics and does all the actual strategying and forecasting and having strategic link ups is brilliant. They're masterful, I would say. They're coming up with contingency plans and theories for every possible scenario that could happen. And Justin Chow is one more tentacle from that machine. So I want you guys to be aware of this guy and just be observant. See if, if you guys are seeing stuff happening in Singapore, see if you see stuff with these security companies, these market makers, routing issues and stuff. Just keep an eye out, be observant, because I'm willing to bet something is happening that we're not seeing. It's much more in depth, and that's kind of it. So keep that in mind. Don't forget about the other gentleman we spoke about, Cho, David Cho, who is chief of security. Interesting stuff happening here. This is wiki page right here, by the way. Just keep an eye out. There's nothing I can infer other than the fact that, hey, this guy is available at Ken's disposal. And anything can happen. So be on your toes. All right. So that's all I have for you. I have not had my cup of coffee this morning. I need my coffee. I have to have my coffee. So forgive me if I'm speaking out of turn or a little bit confused this morning. But thank you very much for watching Alpha Boston out.